There is an interesting question that worship leaders need to answer, but oftentimes they don't even ask. And that question is this: what is my job? If you ask some, the job of worship leader is to bring in the Spirit of God. For some, it's simply to sing a song. You kind of get a lot of different answers. And one thing that I want to bring a lot of clarity on is this. Let's look at Hebrews chapter 10, verse 19. Therefore, brothers, since we have confidence to enter the holy places by the blood of Jesus. By the blood of Jesus. Now, notice that worship leaders are not responsible for bringing people into the presence of God. That's not their job. That's something that Jesus did through his blood. Okay? So that really makes it, should make us ask the question, so what is my job as a worship leader? First off, it's to show them how. It's to show the congregation how to worship. If you are expecting everybody in your congregation to worship and you are not, it's not going to work. If you are expecting everybody in your congregation to really get into it because you're singing a popular song, that's not going to work. You have to mean the words that you say. You can't just sing them well. You have to mean them. Okay, it's good to have talent, it's good to practice, but if you don't mean the words that you're singing, it's nothing. So the first thing that it's your job to do is show them how to worship. The second thing is give them opportunity to worship. Okay, so you're showing them how to worship, you're giving them opportunity to worship. Now, it's not your job to enter them into God's presence. Absolutely not. I'm totally agreeing. Okay, but that still doesn't mean that you're not responsible to show them how to worship and then send off to give them the opportunity to worship. If you're singing a song and then you break up the song just to give a little sermonette about something that you read in the Bible or something that impresses you or to condemn them for not worshiping the way that you want, that's not going to fly. Some people are vocal worshipers, some people are not. Some people look like they're getting nothing and they're getting a lot from it. And some people look like they're getting a lot from it, but they're not getting anything from it. You can't judge by appearance. It's not even your job to judge or to correct them. Your job is to lead the worship, right? Which, as I've said, you're showing them how to worship. So you yourself are worshiping. You're more interested in honoring God in that service than in criticizing and critiquing how they worship God in that service. That has to be your motive. If you're always expecting them and wanting to change them, you're never going to actually yourself draw near to God. Because your whole time, your whole effort is going to be directed at them. What are they doing? So show them how to worship. Give them opportunity to worship. Craft a good worship service. Craft it. Think about it. Think about your keys. Don't let it be just boring music that you do the same time signatures. Always in 4-4. It's always the same tempo. It's always this. Even the same songs. If you do the same songs over and over again, that's okay. You can do them different every time. I mean, you can still stick to the main idea of the song, but maybe sometimes open it up slowly. Sometimes start on the chorus. Sometimes have like a little interlude in it. That's okay. You don't always have to do the same thing over and over again. Give them opportunity to worship. Give them opportunity by how well you plan it out. By how good songs are theologically. By how much you mean songs. Give them opportunity. The third thing. So, okay, show them how. That was number one. Give them opportunity. That was number two. Number three, create an atmosphere of worship. Create an atmosphere of worship. When you are leading worship, you need to have the attitude in you, God, I'm here for you. I'm here to glorify you. I'm not here to get noticed. I'm not here for people to think how awesome I am. I'm not here to change the world. I'm here just to give you glory and honor, God. That's it. That's it. You have to have that attitude in your person, and you have to cultivate it in your team, all the time cultivate it, because you might be there with honorable intentions, but check it out, your worship team might not be. Remember that. Just because you have talented people on your worship team doesn't mean you have the right people on your worship team. And I will tell you this, the heart trumps the talent every time. Practice, 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 but the heart will always trump the talent. Okay, so you're showing them how. You're giving them opportunity to worship. You're creating an atmosphere of worship. Not just by what you do on the stage, but what you do with your team, by what you do off the stage. You're creating an atmosphere of worship that when they get there, they will start to focus and draw near unto God because you are showing them because you are giving them opportunity to. Okay? And then the last thing, excuse me. So show them how, give them opportunity, create atmosphere, model off stage. Oftentimes worship leaders and worship teams, they get on the stage and they're a completely different person than they are in real life. In real life, they do stuff to undermine the leadership of the church, stuff to do stuff behind their back because they're the spiritual ones. They'll post stupid stuff on Facebook. They'll get in fights all the time. They won't show and model holiness. And then they get on the stage and they do a great performance, but it's phony. It's not real. Okay? So the fourth thing, model off stage what you want them to do when you are on stage. Okay, Romans 12:1 talks about presenting our lives as worship to God. It doesn't say present a perfect song. It doesn't say be perfect at what you do in leading worship. It doesn't say all those things. Now, obviously, do what you do with excellence. I'm not saying that. Okay, keep practicing, keep doing better, keep striving to do a better job. Yes, absolutely. But remember, at the end of the day, you have to be genuine and you have to be transparent. Okay, you have to present your life to God as worship. And in that presentation of yourself, you will find that others will follow suit. But here's the thing, you have to be patient because you can't lead people in worship with false motives. Now, what is a false motive in leading worship? I am leading worship so that I will get a reaction from them. That's not leading worship. That's looking for a reaction. When you are leading worship, you are not looking for a reaction. You are leading worship. But they don't do that, but they never get into it. But I feel awkward every week. I feel like I'm doing a terrible job. You keep doing a better job, and you leave their hearts to God. Because like we looked at, we do not enter into God's presence by our skill, but by the blood of Jesus.